Good day, fellow investors. We're approaching the end of the month and it's time for the free stocks to buy in September 2017 video. Now, I always do new stocks and I'm very excited about this video because some things happened that lowered temporary short-term the prices of great stocks. And I will discuss two great stocks and one cigar butt in order to see what a cigar butt is and perhaps you like the investment idea. So let's immediately start with the first stock I would recommend buying now in September 2017, and that is Nike. Let's first see what happened. Nike performed extremely well in the last 5 years, but then peaked 2 years ago and then traded sideways and now is at almost multi-year lows. Nevertheless, the stock price is lower. There hasn't been appreciation, but the fundamentals have constantly improved in the last 2 years also. What happened is that Foot Locker sent out lower numbers, terrible numbers, and now people are afraid that the athleisure trend is fading. There will have been some negative stories around and stock price suffered. However, the fundamental is still there. Let's dig into it. The problem is that analysts look only what happens in the short term and what happens in the US. However, Nike is an international company, less and less dependent on the US. If we look here, Jefferies warned that there will be a disaster for Nike because the Adidas brand is rising, so threatening Nike, and there is less buzz about the near-term pipeline. However, the secular industry tailwinds still exist. So what will happen, what will improve in the long term, so more than 2 quarters, will be very positive. And they lowered the price target from 75 to 60. Usually after lowering, there will be improvements, so a good time to buy. Let's now compare Nike's revenues with Foot Locker's. Foot Locker sales dropped 6%, okay, but Nike's revenues were up 5%. Diluted earnings per share increased 22%. Whole 2017 revenues were up 6%, and diluted earnings per share increased 16%. Inventories just up 4%, even with revenue increasing 6%. So Nike is just selling shoes elsewhere. People are not buying in Foot Locker, but they are still buying shoes through different channels. Nike doesn't care where they sell their shoes. If they sell online with higher margins, better than sell to through Foot Locker. So interesting short-term developments, however the long-term trend is still there. In addition, Foot Locker has $1 billion in cash. They are still positive, they are still operating, they will still continue to buy Nike shoes. So no threat there. Another piece of negative news is John Zolidis telling the world that the athleisure trend is down and Nike, Lululemon, Under Armour are going to be in severe trouble in the next few years. This just came with the last Foot Locker news and the stock price suffered. However, if we go back just a month ago to July 20, Morgan Stanley on the other hand says that Nike has to be upgraded, price target goes from 56 to 68, which now implies a 24% upside. And of course, North America sales will be stable. However, new products, international business, which represents 53% of sales, remains very strong. So if you look at the long term for Nike, very positive. But just the last months has been a sequence of negative news. In the fundamentals, in the sales, nothing has changed. The stock price dropped, creating a buying opportunity. Let's take a look at the financials. In the last 10 years, Nike almost doubled revenue and it lowered shares by about 15%. So the earnings are divided through less shares thanks to buybacks. The buybacks are continuing. Now, the company expects to hit $50 billion in revenue in 2020. They are now at $34 billion. If they grow $2-3 billion per year in the next 3 years, they will come to $40-45 billion. That's not enough to reach $50 billion, but who cares about the $50 billion? You always have to shoot for the sun and then you'll hit the moon. If you shoot for the neighbor's fence, you'll hit the neighbor's fence, very probably. So even if it's $45 billion, that's 20% higher than now. With the margins, with the buybacks, Nike's earnings per share will probably grow from the current $2.5 to perhaps $3.5. If we attach the same price earnings ratio of now of around 20, 3.5 times 20, you are already at 75, which is a nice upside. if Nike manages to grow faster, then we are already talking much, much higher levels. But let's focus on the fundamentals and earnings. There are positive catalysts for Nike that haven't yet come out. Those are 3D printing shoes. I have been supervising a student that worked for Nike headquarters in the Netherlands for Europe, and they have been developing 3D printing soles. She didn't give me the measurements of Cristiano Ronaldo's foot, but she has them, and they try to make soles 3D printed to make as fast as possible. So we can expect disruption in that environment, and Nike is investing very heavily in that disruption. So we can expect something very positive in the future. Something will work, something won't work, but remember, Nike is probably the company that's going to make it work. Further, there is the Jordan brand and all other brands that are going to spread out into women's wear, children's wear, whatever, in order to increase revenue. And finally, the big plan is to conquer China like they did with Europe and the US in the past. From a fundamental perspective, you can see here which brands are expected to grow how much until 2020. E-commerce, especially globally around the world, India is developing. People are also buying Nikes there because Nike has an extremely strong brand. If everything develops in the long term, I think Nike will hit earnings per share of 4-5 in the next 5 years, definitely. With growth, with the developing, with more people entering the middle class around the world and buying Nike shoes. So that's a very positive. The brand is very strong. Everything they do is very planned, very big. They have a moat, let's say, because probably you have some Nikes in your closet. Therefore, EPS of 4, just put the valuation you think a company, growth company like Nike that doubles revenues in the last 10 years should have, and then you have your target price in the next 3-5 years. Thanks to the negative news, the stock price is lower, making it a great buy. The second stock I want to discuss is Qualcomm. Now, people expect linearity. They expect that revenues will grow every quarter at the same pace. But that doesn't work like that, especially in the technology field where Qualcomm operates. New mobile phones, new technologies, there is boom and busts. Skip this, stick to this, then it explodes. And I think Qualcomm is in a negative trend with the lawsuit from Apple and all those negative things. However, the business is very strong, the fundamentals are strong, the company is profitable, and the stock price is much lower than it was, which creates another buying opportunity. Similar situation as with Nike. Strong secular tailwinds, trends, but negative short-term environment. Excellent buying opportunity. Such companies are usually the ones that you say, oh, why didn't I buy them when they recover with their stock price? Let's see the stock price. You can see here how it was extremely high in 2014, then it dropped, then it reached again a level almost 70, now we are at 50. The drop in the stock price is due to revenue stalling in the last 3-4 years. However, in the last 10 years, Qualcomm has tripled its revenue. If you look at dividends, they are 4 times what they have been. The number of shares is also declining. Book value is doubled. And earnings per share are also much, much higher with the current temporary lower place. The expected earnings are, I think, $4.5 for 2017 and $3.8 for 2018. So you have a very low forward price earnings ratio, but that's not it. And you have a good dividend, which will be discussed later. Nevertheless, there is plenty more for Qualcomm. Qualcomm produces and licenses its production of semiconductors for the mobile industry. They have a licensing business, $7.7 billion, semiconductor business, $15.4 billion in revenue. Their strategy is to be the leader in mobile, wireless data transformation, and in the automotive industry, which is becoming more and more wireless, more data, more processing, especially with autonomous drive and all the trends that are going to become huge in the next 10-20 years. And Qualcomm is excellently positioned to take advantage of those trends. They are trying to buy NXP semiconductors, which is very big in the automotive industry, and of course their revenue is expected to increase 50% thanks to the acquisition. They're going to pay a lot for it. Nevertheless, the synergies, the combination should be very, very good. And NXP is not a losing company that there is a turnaround. They're already profitable. What are they going to be when they combine a lot of infotainment, safety, everything that needs technology in a car? On top of the mobile side, the car development, the next thing in the mobile environment, and you want to position yourself now for that thing, is the 5G technology. We want more data. I need more data. I would love that this video, as I'm filming it, it's immediately online, fastly, quickly, not that I have to upload for hours on YouTube, because I need more data. And that's why we all need it, and 5G will be crucial in the development of the world in the next 10, 20 years. Which company is the leader in 5G? Qualcomm. Emerging market mega trend. China is still at 4G, they skipped 3G, and now they are going into 5G. Perhaps not yet, but slowly they will definitely go. Especially when we need to connect all the data we have in order to take advantage of what the technology gives us. On the fundamentals side, Qualcomm has $18 billion in cash, but that they are going to use that cash in order to buy NXP semiconductors. So, okay, they are buying something hopefully valuable, especially valuable if you look at the future and the growth. They have constantly been increasing the quarterly dividend. Their dividend yield now is around 4% or even a bit higher. So you are buying a company that pays a nice dividend and expected to continue to do so in the future. So you have a growth company exposed to big trends with a dividend yield. Therefore, Qualcomm, if you think a little bit long term, take advantage of the short term negativism around the company. There are some lawsuits, some licensing lawsuits, but okay, if they lose from Apple, they'll lose 1.5 or 1.2 billion. That's nothing with the compared to the 18 billion they have on the balance sheet. So think about that and think how short term, think about the impact and the weight of the short term negative information in the long term automotive 5G trends, mobile, wireless, and what everything was going on in the world. So really think about buying Qualcomm. Similar to Nike, so I'm very excited about this month's video. The third company I want to discuss is A.H. Bella. It's a newspaper, printing newspapers. Very old business, declining, negative trend. You don't want to buy a newspaper. Why am I recommending it? Because I want you to buy the cash on the balance sheet and the building they have, which is going to be sold. So this is a cigar butt. According to Benjamin Graham, you're picking a cigar butt from the street, but it has one or two puffs left in it. That was from the 1950s, but it's interesting to see how still there are such opportunities. I'll shortly discuss the stock now. So I wrote a Seeking Alpha article in 2015 about the company. The stock price was where it was now, then it went up almost to 8, and now it declined to 4.7 again. This is normal for the company because it takes time to sell the real estate. There hasn't been a special dividend since 2014, but now is the time to do that because when they announce a special dividend, which will be, who knows, last time was $2.2, you can get 50% back on your investment very, very quickly. What do they have? They have the Dallas News, morning news, and they have $80 million in cash or $3.63 per share. Next, they have this building behind me and they have two parking lots and another land lot in Dallas, which is now for sale. They are moving their headquarters, everything from the big building, and they are transferring to a smaller building because paper printed is dead, let's say. The value of this building and other buildings, about $45 million expected, plus the cash, you are at around $5.68 per share. So when they sell it, expected sale is about in the next 12 to 18 months, there'll be plenty of cash, and the intention of the company is to pay out that cash to shareholders. Now, there is a little catch there, but that depends how you value the printed business, printing newspaper, and how you value the digital online marketing agencies that they have. They have a few businesses, the Dallas Morning News, and are then some Dallas Morning Media and other online platforms. Now those, the Dallas Morning News has some pension liabilities, $47 million, but if the company could sell that for $1, that's unlikely. Perhaps they will get 10, 20 millions for the business, for the digital side or something like that. Then that's upside. However, they will probably sell it for $1. So what's left is $5.6 of value. Plus, that's the margin of safety. Plus, there is always potential that they get more. So if they get 20, 30, 40 billion, million, that's $1, $2 more from that. So if you buy AH Bello now, you pay 4.7 for something that has the minimum value of 5.6 with potential to go to 7 to 8. That's called net-net cigar butt investment idea. I hope you like the free stocks to buy now. Very interesting companies. Really good opportunity to take advantage now. Of course, everything can go negatively, but that's the stock market. Be ready to average down because the companies are really, really good. Strong brands, strong moats, strong technology and strong development, except for AH Bello, which is a real estate play. Thank you for watching. Consider subscribing if you like the content. Every month I give free new stocks to buy, the most interesting stocks that I find on the stock market. Click like if you like the content, and I'll see you in the next video.